just left the marina, 115 Brooklyn Marina, and we're heading up the Hudson River today to go to Rockland County. Nyack, I think we're staying in Nyack tonight, and that's where Jeff was, he was raised there. He grew up his whole life there. So he's excited to go anchor right outside where he grew up. And it should be a 3.5 or 4 hour trip, something like that. There's a big ass barge. And I think we're gonna let him cross in front of us.
We see that guy, right?
Yeah, I think that's why Jeff is trying to decide what to do.
I was like, okay.
Yeah, so when we jumped out of the marina, we had to go really fast because the current was insane. And we didn't really cut in front of the Manhattan ferry. We crossed his bow and we were pretty far away from him, but he was not happy about it. And he blew his horn probably 12 or 15 times. But you know what? We had to save ourselves. Oh, and there's Statue of Liberty. That is so cool. Let this guy go by and then we're gonna go around. Unfortunately, we're not gonna catch video of us tying up at the fuel dock because there's so much wind and current, we're gonna need everybody on deck.
And we're gonna go up the river to Rockland County where I grew up. We're gonna pass the George Washington Bridge and then go up to the Tappan Zee Bridge, which is the Mario Kart Bridge.
Well, another show is over and it's time to go home. I gotta pack up my gear, I gotta get on the road. See a storm is rising out of Jackson's Bay. And if I don't leave now, I'm gonna have to stay. Well, I've been away for a long, long time.
Jeff wants me to go outside and film this because we're going under the Tappan Zee Bridge. It's freaking cold. It's cold, it's windy, it's bouncy. Totally not like summer at all. Have a look.
God, it's freezing. There's so much wind, I can barely open the door.
There, that's the Tappan Zee Bridge. Jeff used to live right over there, somewhere.
It's freaking miserable.
See you later, alligator. Java to go. It's 4 in the morning and it's time to snow. But my baby's waiting at the other end.
We are 25 miles up the Hudson River or so. We're in Nyack, New York. It's my hometown, or a few towns away from my hometown, but it's my home county. And we're anchored out there in the Hudson, over there somewhere. And we stay at what's called the Nyack Boat Club. And they come and pick us up on their little shuttle. So we don't have to take the dinghy down. And we're just gonna go walk around Nyack right now. And we used to go drinking here a lot. As a matter of fact, we had dinner last night at the bar that when I was a teenager, we used to go and sneak in and watch bands play and drink beer.
Say what?
I said, what are we gonna do today?
It's my birthday, so we're gonna do something fun.
It's your birthday. We're gonna walk around town for a couple hours?
Yeah.
The only problem with this town is it's up a hill.
Yes, it's good.
Coming
it's
back
up
a hill.
Okay. Yeah, coming back is okay.
We get on the boat. Yeah. We need some exercise.
I'm sitting here doing this.
In the summertime, I'm pulling into town with my radio on and the drop top. Really brings me down. I gotta hit the road and get the heck up out of town. Wow. push it up to 140, hear the engine wave. In a couple more miles, I'm gonna be home free. You're the sweet, sweet bone you're gonna pick with me.
So we've got this really interesting anchorage we're at right now, and I'll show you why. We've got, where's my finger? Here's the finger. We've got Jersey City. We've got Ellis Island. We've got Lower Manhattan, Upper Manhattan. We've got the Brooklyn Bridge is somewhere over there. Then we got Brooklyn over there. And then we got Lady Liberty herself right behind us. And if you want to add to it, down there, I don't know if you can see it, we got the Verrazano Bridge. Trying to fix our wind instrument. The wind instrument is broken, and when we're trying to fix it, I unplugged something and we plugged something back in and it broke. So we needed one of these. So there's a hardware store in New Jersey. I'm sorry. There's an electrical supply store in New Jersey called City Electric Supply. So we went in, and we said, I just need these. And he's like, okay, just take it. I'm like, well, I don't want to just take one. He's like, what are you gonna do, buy the whole box and then just have it sitting there for no reason? He goes, just take it. I'm like, really? So he gave us like a bunch of these and didn't charge us, but really awesome guys inside City Electric Supply. These guys are really nice.
In Jersey City.
And we're in Jersey City, yeah. So I figured we'd show them. But yeah, it was so nice.
Among all the chaos that is New York City, we find this. Out for a morning stroll. So this is Jara and Veronica, and we're here in Jersey City. We were going a little slower than we thought we should be going, so we thought maybe we picked up a bunch of growth in St. Augustine. And we were walking down the dock, and these two were cleaning somebody else's boat. We're like, can you please clean our boat before we leave tomorrow? I'll give you banana bread. And they're like, sure. So here they are, and they cleaned the bottom last minute, did a great job.
The boat's over there,
Price.
The boat's over there.
The boat's over there. And yeah, so we're very, very
so
excited.
Dive Tech, Jersey City.
Yeah, Dive Tech, Jersey City.
And pretty much you had this marina?
Yes.
Yeah.
This marina, Havistraw, Nyack, Keyboard, Raritan.
Oh, really? You guys up there?
We have a boat to go miles.
Oh, we were just
up for Connecticut.
Oh, we were just up in Nyack.
We go.
Okay, yeah. Well, guys.
Dive Tech, D-I-V-E-T.
T-E-C-H.
They're awesome. Yes. We love them. They're really happy that they were here. Thank you guys so much for doing it.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Today we're leaving Jersey City and we're going up the East River of Manhattan through Hell's Gate into Long Island Sound. We're going to try to end up at Huntington, Long Island tonight. We got to wait till 1 o'clock in the afternoon though, because that's when the current changes in the East River. Otherwise, we get the crap beaten out of us with the tide. So, according to all the charts and according to Eldridge, the chart book, the tide and current book, it shows 1 o'clock is when we should start up the river. So we're gonna go past Manhattan and Brooklyn, up to underneath the Brooklyn Bridge. It's gonna be epic today. A little worried because there's a ton of boat traffic and a lot of current. We'll see what happens. But really, it should be a really unique, interesting day. Certainly, we're not in the Bahamas anymore. I got to see a bunch of my old coworkers, because my office used to be in Jersey City right up the road over there. So I got to see them, some of my old ex-coworkers for lunch, and they're all doing great. So that made me feel good that everyone's happy there at DTCC. Anyway, we're gonna head out in 5 minutes.
driver right back, fish to 1-3.
1-3. Robert Burton is with therapy. Would you guys be okay if we passed you on your port side now? Over.
Yeah, I'll be in Manhattan.
Come back with that.
I'll be on the Manhattan side of the river, so you got this entire Brooklyn side to yourself.
Okay, so we'll come back on your starboard side then. Over.
That's right.
Okay, thanks. With that, we're back to 1-2.
Too young to have a chip on your shoulder. Do some time and call me when you're older. Get your ass in the van, pay some dues and hit the road. This ain't a landing hell, and no deals being made at the crossroads.
So we were sailing up the East River, motoring. We were motoring up the East River, and everything's going great. And we went down below because I heard something, and it turns out the water pump was on and our port bilge light was on. And that's not really good. And then we looked a little further and we realized that we had a full tank of water, and now we have a half a tank of water. So clearly a problem. Adrian discovered it. What the problem was, and let's go down below and see what she has to say. You gonna talk about the first problem? Yeah. Want me to go show that first problem?
Okay. So I came down here, and I picked up this floor, and there's our bilge pump, and there was a lot of water. And I looked in that corner way up there, and there was something like spinning around in that corner.
Spinning around?
Yeah.
Like a top?
No, it was like two pieces of schmutz.
Two pieces of dirt?
Two pieces of... And they were kind of like spinning, like dancing around.
Kind of like the tide in Hell's Gate, only smaller.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, it's like the tide in Hell's Gate.
Only... So I thought, well, what would cause that besides running water? So... Oh, and the float switch was... up, but the bilge pump was not pumping water.
But that's a problem.
That is a problem. So then I came up here, and I picked up this floor.
Oh, she picked up that floor.
And I saw that this whole floor was wet.
Wet.
And I saw water running in from over there.
From
that direction.
That direction there.
Yeah.
Okay, so now we gotta track it back.
So now I figured, oh no, it has to be coming from here. So I threw everything off the bed.
A lot of shit on the bed.
And I opened this.
This is where our water maker is.
And this was had about an inch and a half of water in it. And this hose right here was off and just spraying water wildly.
Which one?
This one right here.
Oh, it was off and spraying water wildly.
Yeah.
And that is our freshwater flush line.
Yeah, that comes directly from the water tanks, which are right here.
Yeah, so it goes from the water tank and it goes to there, and that's what flushes the water maker.
So we lost about 50 gallons of water.
Yeah, 50 gallons of water and a very wet bilge. And at least we know it drains properly in here.
Well, I dried it up too.
But it was draining.
Yeah, it was.
So there's never like one problem. It's always, problems happen, it's always like twos or threes, it seems. So problem one was that was like water, the hose was flopping around and we lost 50 gallons of water poured into our bilge over here.
So I fixed that problem. So then, came back over here, picked up this floor while it was up.
Yeah, we saw the water rushing in there.
Well, now there's no more water rushing, but...
Where'd all the water go?
It's still in there.
Oh. So the float switch wasn't floating. Was floating, but the water wasn't pumping out.
There you go.
Right? But yeah. But did you hear the pump on?
Yeah, the pump was on, but nothing was happening.
So the pump was on, but water wasn't... So nothing it was sucking was water out,
Well, it wasn't sucking water out. The pump was on.
Which means it's sucking water out.
But it didn't. It wasn't pushing any water. So I came up here.
Loud and clear.
To the manual pump, and I tried to pump manually. And it didn't pump anything.
Okay.
So I climbed down in here.
Did you climb down in there?
I climbed down in here, and I picked up the float switch. And then I started getting sprayed on from my shoulders. And I'm, how's that possible? The water was coming in from under here. So I said, oh, it's gotta be coming from here. So I thought, oh, it's the air conditioner. But then I looked under here and everything down here was wet. There's water just pouring down from that hose right there, which actually leads up to the back of that manual bilge pump here. So there's a problem with this manual bilge pump. There's a leak somewhere in one of these hoses or in the pump itself, and we can't get any suction to pump out any water.
I'm gonna use the grabber, and I'm gonna do the grabbing, and I'm gonna pull up the float switch, and then Adrian's gonna check, see if it spews out at her.
Okay.
Again, her face. Ready?
Yeah.
The pumping?
Well, I hear the pump on. It's not pumping, though. You'd hear it.
Well, where did all the water go then? It's an airlock, probably.
Pick it up and put it down a couple of times real fast. Okay, knock on the... You're going to have... You want me to get down in there?
Knock on what?
The hose. The out hose. If there's an air bubble, you're
gonna... Oh, there you go.
Okay, here we go. Oh, shit. Well, that's the problem. That's the problem. Look at that.
This is the second time today Adrian's let me use a power tool.
Wow.
Yeah.
You've been a good boy.
And we don't know if taking this off is going to do anything, but we're going to check.
Well, we just have to be able to get to it.
Oh, you said it's turning.
Turn it 1 inch to 1 inch clockwise.
Oh, look at that. As far as it goes.
Well, we can pull the hose out. I'm gonna pull the hose off of it from the other side.
Oh, yeah. So we're trying to get the hoses off so we can pull this thing out.
The ratcheting part of this isn't working, but at least I can. Can you push the whole thing to port to starboard, please?
Like that?
No more. Okay, push it back toward me and then push it. There you go. Thanks.
You're welcome.
I don't know how the hell these people work like this. They must have done this before they put the air conditioner in. I never thought that there would be... I mean, I knew that I didn't know a lot about the boat, but I never realized how much I didn't know. But the more we dive into this, the longer we live here, the more I realize, the less I know. But this whole piece right here broke in half. No. Okay, well, nevertheless, we need a new one. We may need a new, whole new one.
Well, we woke up this morning to, we're leaving Huntington Bay, somewhere on Long Island, and we're gonna head towards the northeast side of Long Island this morning, but we got like 55 miles to go, so we wanted to leave a little bit early. So it's daytime, but I don't think we're leaving just yet because it looks like this out there, and maybe the camera's not capturing it, but you can't see more than like 20 feet in front of the boat. It's just like a complete whiteout.
We gave our bell away, our ship's bell away, not realizing we needed it. So we need to get a new ship's bell for reasons like this.
Learn to live. Learn to breathe. ship, so in the captain's. Calypso in the captain's. Wind therapy. We all need wind therapy.